Hello everybody, this is Angie, and I have a new project for you. If you use Sizzix dies, and you have these particular various Sizzix dies, you can make something other than what it was meant to be. And I just discovered it, and I'm really excited to start showing it to you, but I'll show you the three dies that I use and what I made from them. First off, this one is called Moorish. You get this cut, which looks like an ornament, and from that cut, I made this little mini enclosure. It can also be a little love note, but it folds like that. This one is retired. This one is called Frame Back Ornate number 7. Looks like that. It gives you this cut, and from that cut, I made this. Another little mini enclosure, or it could be mini, it could be a lot of things. I'll show you later, because it can also be a little envelope. These all can be envelopes, but this one can be like a little pocket. And that's frame back ornate number 7. And then this last one, which I like the best, this one is called Frame Back Ornate number 3. You get this cut. And from this one, I made this little mini enclosure. Isn't that sweet? This is my favorite because it's so different in the way that they have these little folds and cuts here. But I will come back. I will do each one and show you how I did it and show you how what fun things you can make with it. Be right back. Now I'm going to go ahead and start off with my favorite. This is called Frame Back Ornate number 3. Looks like this. And you get the cut that looks like this. Now, what I've already showed you is the folds that I made. You start off with going into the corner, and that's the easiest. Once you have that done, you're going to be able to make it all. So you go into this corner, you fold here and here. Then you come back, and you do these two little lips. Fold, I know I'm getting glare, here and here. And as you can see, when you look on the other side, you have a square or something that looks like a square. Now, the only thing I had to do a little bit of to get it to enclose, I did a little bit of trimming, not much, but on one of them I had to do a little bit of trimming on one side so that it wouldn't overlap. But look at how cute that comes out. I know I have a lot of glare on this camera or with this lighting. But this is the first enclosure I made, and it's so much fun. And you could either make this into a little enclosure envelope or write a sweet note, an encouragement or something. If you're giving a gift, you put that into the gift. You write who it's from, close it up, and voila, you have a gift enclosure. And again, it looks really neat on the other side too, because it's more like a rectangle. But I made this out of this. Isn't that fun? Okay, I'll come back and do the next. Okay, this die I recently bought, and it's called Moorish. And it comes out looking like this ornament. And I was playing with this one first because I got a sample, and I opened it up and saw the sample and was playing with that. But this is what you get. Now, you could do it any way you want, but the first thing I did was go into these corners, and all you need to do is like put your fingernail in there or whatever, fold that down, give it a good, you could use your bone folder if you have one to make it neater, give it a good fold. Take the other corner, which is the other point, you go into these two corners, you also fold that down, and give it a good fold. Then you go into this corner, Same thing, corner to corner. Pull it down. Fold. Go into this corner, corner to corner. Pull it down. Fold. And voila! Turn, 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 and mini envelope! Yay! And that's what I use. That's how I made out this one. Isn't that sweet? And of course, again, you could, these are my little dollar stamps. I went ahead and, since it's close to Valentine's Day, I put a little stamp in there and put little mini hearts inside. But again, it could be any for any function that you have and for a little gift enclosure. And it just goes so quickly and so easily. And you come up with these. And again, that's using the Sizzix die called Moorish. And I will be right back to do the third one. Oops! Sorry about that. Third one, last but not least. I think this one might actually be retired, but you might have it. It's called Frame Back Ornate Number 7. And you get this cut, which is the frame back. Now, this is a little bit more of a challenge, and I'll show you. For some reason, the first one that I made came out great. After that, I was tinkering around, and they just came a little bit off. So my advice, cut a couple of them with paper, work with it, and then you'll see exactly how you want to make them. But anyway, again, you have this cut. The first thing you do is go into this corner right up here. Well, not, it doesn't have to be the first. You could do it in any way. Pull this down and fold. Same thing on this. Go to this, let me pull this back, that'll be easier. Go right here in this corner, pull it down, fold. Go into this corner, pull it down, fold. And same thing here, this corner, pull it down, oops. Fold. As you can see, I'm using the sample that I had already finished up. This one comes out a little bit differently, and you can kind of do different things with it. The first thing I did was to make this little enclosure envelope. It looks like this. It is different. And of course, that's how it looks. They all look very, very neat from the front. But then I noticed you could also, if you want to do a little pocket, you could do that. You would have to, of course, glue this down, and then I just tuck this. If you want to make the pocket, glue, let's see, not glue this down, put a little dab of glue right here and close this side. Oh, I should close that side up, then put glue here, close that side up, and then you have the pocket. So you have more things that you could do with. You could actually do that with each of these, but the other pockets would be really tiny. But I mean, if that's what you want to do, of course, it's your die. You have fun with it, but this is what it comes out to be. So I hope you've had fun watching my ways of using Sizzix dies to do something other than what they were meant to be and make little mini enclosures. You can make mini correspondence. You could tuck these into gifts. You could, it would kind of work as an envelope, but I think it would be better to write your little note in here and then enclose it and tuck that into a gift or, you know, your child's backpack, give a little note of encouragement to anybody, but it can be a gift enclosure, a little love note. And I'm doing this just before Valentine's Day, so that would be a great thing to do. And let's see. Oh, yeah. If you have any questions on this project, please feel free to jot it down there. And this is Angie. I am wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.